Have I got a story for you guys. First off, on this GoPro, this is unrelated. I'm not feeling the GoPro. It seems, of course, it's better in outside and it looks clear. Every video I film inside the garage, in my screen at least, it's blurry. Maybe my monitor is larger than 1080p. Maybe that's the problem. And when I go full screen, it's more than the video. I'm expanding it. I mean, unless you guys see it crystal clear, I don't think you do. I'm not impressed with the Hero 7 quality. I think my Hero 4 Plus Silver was just as good, and it might even be better. And I'm thinking about going back to find some old stock on a Hero 4 Silver. I don't think there's much point in the 7, as I haven't seen the quality improve in the videos at all. I mean, fair enough, it's to do with lighting and stuff. But let's get into it with what the heck I had to make you this video for. First off, let's refresh on our piping situations here, okay? So we have the 2019 resonator, right? Let me see here. And just for an example, that is how loose your clamp is with the 237 that we talked about, right? This is what your clamp should be on a 2.5, crystal clear, crystal tight. Now, you know the muffler that was on the other end of this cut is over here with the tips. You know that it was also too small. Check it out now. Jeez, almost too big. But the clamp is fully tightened. I can loosen it a bit. Look at that. Look how tight that is. Yes, I somehow mastered and mix mastered this whole issue with my exhaust. Oh, it's still burning hot. My exhaust expander, which has saved me so many times on all these jobs. That kit over there, which it's kind of a poor man's exhaust expander kit. And believe me, I was cranking this so hard without an impact socket, which is dangerous, wearing glasses, of course. And I was laying this under there for protection in case it all exploded, for just extra safety. But somehow I just cranked and cranked, and no splits in the pipe without getting anything messed up. All of a sudden I pulled it off and I could not believe my absolute perfection in look. So I believe at this point I can fit this muffler directly onto my old 2.5 pipe, as I have now enlarged this to 2.5. Super sick, super official. That's some food channel I watched. Damn Eats? I don't know. Something there. So I can just turn this down a little bit. Of course, it sucks when you're trying to hold a camera and film and wrench all with one arm when your one arm's in a sling. I can't do it. All right, you get the idea. I believe I have fixed this issue, and I went in far enough to make sure I get a super, super sick clamp bead on that. So I couldn't believe my luck, as I spent all morning just looking for clamps, and obviously nobody makes the clamp we need. A 60 to 63, I checked everything all over the world. It's all off sizes. It's like 57 to 60 or 63 to 67. There's nothing in between. Exactly what I needed, a 60 to 63. So I believe I have solved this myself. Look at the, I'm surprised how nice a transition this is too for a home exhaust expander here. Very, very stock, very smooth. It doesn't look super hokey or anything. It actually looks just like the kind of things you'd buy in the store as far as an expander. So I am going to be at some point putting this muffler on, and I just saved myself all that money that I spent. The thing is, after all this work, I want to take a polisher to it, just like my other one. Geez, that's a hard choice. I could save that for a later project, I suppose, but I kind of wanted it to be polished, just like just like the other one. But of course, in my condition, it's really not the time to be polishing it. I am mostly protecting my arm, doing almost nothing with it, like I should be doing almost nothing. So I'm kind of working one-handed. Just wanted to share that news with you, and that I think I've solved this issue. I can't even believe it. Super stoked. If any of you've mentioned, one guy mentioned a club sport he got that was the wrong size. Now, it depends if you're the direction I was going, or if you're the opposite way. You can't shrink a pipe. But you might keep, if you make a big spend and somehow it won't fit, you might consider, I'm sure this was less than $100, investing in a kit like this and doing your own small tweak to a size to salvage a project that may have got wrecked because of the wrong size or something. Anyway, I think I got it. I know I got it. Just wanted to let you guys know. I'm not excited about trying to get this thing up there and to fit with one hand, but I'm going to think about it. So I'll see you guys later. All right, guys, let me show you what we freaking got. Killer. Perfect. I just about got this synced up here, aimed up, and I'm just going to adjust it a little bit, get it just where it should go, and then tighten it a bit, and we should be good to go. So looks like it's going to be good.